नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम डॉक्टर भारत शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पैथोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज इश्चेमिक हार्ट डिजीज। नाउ, मायोकार्डियल ब्लड सप्लाई। फर्स्ट वी अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द मायोकार्डियल ब्लड सप्लाई हैपेंस। The cardiac muscle, in order to function properly, must receive adequate supply of oxygen and nutrients. Blood is transported to myocardial cells by the coronary arteries, while which originate immediately above the aortic semilunar valve. Most of the blood flow to the myocardium occurs during diastole. There are three major coronary trunks, each supply blood to specific segment of the heart. The first is anterior descending branch of the left coronary artery, commonly called LAD, left anterior descending coronary artery, supplies most of the apex of the heart, the anterior surface of the left ventricle, the adjacent third of the anterior wall of the right ventricle, and the anterior two-third of the interventricular septum. Second is the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery, commonly called LCX, supplies the left atrium and a small portion of the lateral aspect of the left ventricle. Third is the right coronary artery, abbreviated as RCA, supplies the right atrium, the remainder of the anterior surface of the right ventricle, the adjacent half of the posterior wall of the left ventricle, and the posterior third of the interventricular septum. There are three anatomic patterns of distribution of the coronary blood supply, depending upon which coronary artery crosses the crux. Crux is the region on the posterior surface of the heart where all the four cardiac chambers and the interatrial and interventricular septa meet. These patterns are as under: right coronary atrial preponderance, balanced cardiac circulation, and left coronary preponderance. Coronary veins run parallel to the major coronary arteries to collect blood after the cellular need of the heart are met. Subsequently, these veins drain into the coronary sinus. Now, ischemic heart disease is defined as acute or chronic form of cardiac disability arising from imbalance between the myocardial supply and demand for the oxygenated blood. Alternate term for coronary artery disease is used synonymously with ischemic heart disease. As per rising trends of ISD worldwide, it is estimated that by the year 2020, it would become the most common cause of death throughout the world. Etiopathogenesis. Ischemic heart disease is invariably caused by disease affecting the coronary arteries, the most prevalent being atherosclerosis, accounting for more than 90% of cases, while other causes are responsible for less than 10% of cases of ischemic heart disease. Coronary atherosclerosis. Coronary atherosclerosis resulting is fixed obstruction is the major cause of ISD is more than 90% cases. First is distribution. Atherosclerotic lesions in coronary arteries are distributed in one or more of the three major coronary arterial trunks, the highest incidences being in the anterior descending branch of the left coronary, followed in decreasing frequency by the right coronary artery, and still less in circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. Second is location. Almost all adults shows atherosclerotic plaques scattered throughout the coronary artery. Arterial system. However, significant stenotic lesions that may produce chronic myocardial ischemia shows more than 75% reduction in the cross-sectional area of a coronary artery or its branch. Third is fixed atherosclerotic plaques. The atherosclerotic plaques is in the coronaries are more often eccentrically located, bulging into the lumen from one side. Occasionally, there may be concentric thickening of the wall of the artery, or atherosclerotic sclerosis produces gradual luminal narrowing that may eventually lead to fixed coronary obstruction. Superadded changes in coronary atherosclerosis. The attack of acute coronary syndromes, which include acute myocardial infarction, unstable angina, and sudden ischemic death, are precipitated by certain changes superimposed on a pre-existing fixed coronary atheromatous plaque. First is acute changes in chronic atheromatous plaque. Though chronic fixed obstructions are the most frequent cause of ischemic heart disease, acute coronary episodes are often precipitated by sudden changes in chronic plaques, such as plaque hemorrhage, fissuring, or ulceration that result in thrombosis and embolization of the atheromatous debris. Second is coronary artery thrombosis. Transmural acute myocardial infarction is often precipitated by partial or complete coronary thrombosis. The initiation of thrombus occurs due to surface ulceration of fixed chronic atheromatous plaque, ultimately causing complete luminal occlusion. Third is local platelet aggregation and coronary artery spasm. Some cases of acute coronary episodes are caused by local aggregates of platelet on the atheromatous plaque, short of forming a thrombus. Now, non-atherosclerotic causes of ischemic heart disease. First is vasospasm, stenosis of coronary ostia, arteritis, embolism, thrombotic disease, trauma, aneurysm, and compression. Effect of myocardial ischemia. Depending upon the suddenness of onset, duration, degree, location, and extent of the area affected by myocardial ischemia, the range of changes and clinical features may range from an asymptomatic state at one extreme to immediate mortality at another. First is asymptomatic state. Second is angina pectoris. Third is acute myocardial infarction. And fourth, chronic ischemic heart diseases, ischemic cardiomyopathy or myocardial fibrosis. And last is sudden cardiac death. The term acute coronary syndrome includes a triad of acute myocardial infarction, unstable angina, and sudden cardiac death. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you all enjoyed this session. If you have any query, please mention it in comment box. Thank you.